Hey guys, welcome back to our channel Naughty Threats. In case you're new here, do consider subscribing and also hit the bell icon to get all the future updates. So in today's video, we'll learn how to make this slanting arch tassels along with crystal beads. It's very pretty and unique design, and the best part is it gets done very fast. You don't have to spend a lot of time to work this design. So that's the highlight of this, and once done, especially if it is done in two colors like this, it looks really really pretty. So stay with me till the end and you will know how easy it is to work this design. And also let me know your thoughts in the comment section. So now without any delay, let's get straight into the video. So for today's design, I am using 6 strands of silk thread in orange color. I'm going to use two colors, so one is pink and the other one is orange. So both I have taken 6 strands, and the needle is going to be the regular one, needle number 10, the one that I normally use. And along with this, you will need some crystal beads like this. This is a 6 mm size. If you want, you can use slightly smaller or bigger. Instead of crystal beads, you can also use pearls or any kind of kuchu beads. So we'll start off by fixing the knot. So the right side of the sari is facing on top. This is how I generally start. I'm going to fix the knot here right in the edge. And then work 5 chains. After 5 chains, I'm going to fix this using a single crochet. Work 5 chains again. I'm going to turn the fabric and fix this 5 chains right here. I'm not doing it in the single crochet, but I'm just doing it in the edge of this chain gap. Now I'm going to turn this back and I'll work 10 to 12 double crochet stitches. The reason why I am saying 10 to 12 is because when you work these chains, maybe you're working slightly smaller chains or bigger chains. So you will have to check how many double crochet stitches is required to fill this complete block. So that is the reason I'm saying 10 to 12. So I'm just going to work these stitches here in this gap, not in between the two chain blocks, but in between the first chain block and the fabric. So this is the 12th stitch. So for the size of chain block I have worked, I need 12 stitches to fill the block. So after 12 stitches, I'm going to fix this by working one single crochet. How you're going to decide the distance is just by placing this wherever the stitch is reaching, just work one single crochet there. And this is where I'm going to add the crystal. So since this is a 6 mm crystal, I'm using needle number 10. In case you're using a smaller crystal, so you will also have to change the needle because needle number 10 will not pass in the hole. So accordingly, use either 12 or 13 number needle to add the bead. And then I'm going to work 5 chains. Turn the work again. Now we'll count 6 stitches from this side, from right to left. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. I'm going to fix this chain block in the 6th stitch with a single crochet and turn the work again and then continue working 12 double crochets in this block. So I have worked 12 double crochets here. So we'll continue the same process. I'm going to fix this using a single crochet. Add the next crystal. And then work 5 chains. Turn the work and fix this on the 6th stitch. Again, turn the work. Now we'll start our double crochets. So each time you will have to work 12 double crochet stitches in this 5 chain block. So if you wish, you can just continue the complete design in single color, but since the saree is double color, I'm going to show you guys how to alternate the colors. So we'll work the same pattern for a certain distance and then we'll add the next color. So if you want to continue in same color, you will just have to repeat the same process and continue working. So this design, the speciality is it will get over in single step. There is no multiple steps and it also looks really different once it is complete. So I'll work for the for a little distance and then we'll see how to add the next color. So now I'm going to join the second color. I worked 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10 arches. So after 10, I'm going to change color. So just trim this off and pull the loop that is on the needle. We are going to fix this later. So my second color is ready here. I have 6 strands of pink. So I'm going to hold both and make a knot here. And then start from the same single crochet. Pull a loop and then I'm going to add a bead. And work 5 chains. After 5 chains, the same process will continue. Fix it on the 6th stitch here. Turn the work and then continue with 12 double crochets. So this is how we'll change the color. Again, after working 10 arches in pink, I'm going to join orange and continue the same way. So after 12, I'm going to fix it using a single crochet. So this is how it look. So I finished working the complete sari. We'll now see how to fix these strands, because everywhere we change the color, you will find this long strand of thread. So I have already fixed it in all other places like this, which will not even be visible. So if you can just notice here, I have glued it to this last arch. So first point, we'll actually trim this, leaving just about an inch long thread here. And then using this fabric glue, I'm going to stick it here in the last arch. So this way, there is no fear of the knot getting loose, and also there is no loose piece of thread visible anywhere. So once you have glued this, make sure you leave it aside for at least 30 to 40 minutes for it to dry. Otherwise, immediately if we reverse this, then it might leave a stain on the sari this side. So for now, I am just going to leave it aside. So this is how it has turned out. So this is how it has turned out. In case sari has multiple colors, like 3 or 4 colors, you can simply use all the colors in the sari. That is going to look really, really pretty. Do give it a try. Try in all variations. I have worked 10 arches here. If you want, you can simply work 5 arches to make it more colorful. So sometimes it might not end with the same number. So I guess that's okay. If you are really keen about it, I would suggest you guys to measure the width of the pallu and then work accordingly. So yeah, I guess that's about it. And though we haven't tied any tassels, the design still looks very elegant and pretty. That's the best part. You can go ahead and suggest this design for your clients who don't like tassels. Because of late, few people have this complaint. They are finding it difficult to maintain the silk thread tassels in the sari. So most of my clients ask for designs which don't have tassels. So this is one tip or just a suggestion from my end. So I guess that's about it. I hope you guys like this video. In case you did, don't forget to give us that thumbs up and keep sharing our videos with your friends. Subscribe to our other channel, Naughty Threads Kannada, as well, where I'm posting only Kannada videos. And do visit our blog, naughtythreads.net, where you will get to see all our Ari work blouse designs and all the kuchu work designs. We are constantly trying to keep it updated. But yeah, keep visiting so that, you know, even you stay updated. I guess that's about it. I shall see you guys soon with more interesting stuff. Until then, take care guys, and bye bye.